by order of the Overseer Council. The following file describes a hostile, anomalous alien superstructure capable of causing an SK-class barren Earth end-of-the-world event, and is level 5-2399 classified. Unauthorized access is forbidden. Item number, SCP-2399. Level 5 Top Secret. Containment Class, Keter. Disruption Class, Amida. Risk Class, Danger. Special Containment Procedures. Due to SCP-2399's location and nature, physical means of containment are currently impossible. Implanted Foundation agents in major observatories are to contain footage or images of SCP-2399. An ongoing misinformation campaign is in effect, which has thus far been able to completely suppress any knowledge pertaining to SCP-2399 from public awareness. Foundation satellites in orbit around Jupiter are to maintain constant vigilance of SCP-2399's reconstruction efforts, and make all attempts to hinder that process should SCP-2399 reach a minimum of 75% completion. Additionally, a perimeter of long-range electromagnetic jamming satellites, known as the Barrier Array, has been situated in high Jupiter orbit. Any transmissions intercepted by this array are to be summarily decoded and logged. In the event of SCP-2399 surpassing 75% completion or an information breach in the jamming perimeter, necessary Foundation personnel will engage Protocol Legionnaire 5, see Addendum 2399-L5, given its completion by that time. Description. SCP-2399 is a massive, complex mechanical structure currently located in Jupiter's lower atmosphere. Since its visual discovery in 1963, SCP-2399 has been observed to use highly advanced antimatter-based weaponry to create spatial disruptions and devastating atmospheric, observable as a large red vortex, commonly known as the Great Red Spot. SCP-2399 appears to be damaged, possibly due to an impact with the moon Io, before coming to rest in its current position. SCP-2399 has been observed releasing a multitude of small octopoid repair drones in efforts to repair the damage it has taken. Some of these drones will remain near SCP-2399, while others will patrol nearby moons or go deeper into the gases of Jupiter itself in search of parts that SCP-2399 is missing. Computer models estimate that SCP-2399 is at 59% completion, with a current rate of 0.78% annually. This rate has increased from an estimated 0.12% in 1970. Despite its damaged state, SCP-2399 seems to possess a limitless power supply, advanced electromagnetic shielding, matter-disrupting weaponry, the ability to repair damage done to itself, and a precise tracking and targeting system. See Addendum 2399-2B. Due to the large difference in technological advancement between the creator of SCP-2399 and our own, for all intents and purposes, SCP-2399 is currently indestructible by human means. In theory, SCP-2399 might be left vulnerable by a powerful enough electromagnetic pulse. Unfortunately, this technology does not yet exist. Since 1971, SCP-2399 has been the recipient of an unending stream of electromagnetic-based communications originating in the Triangulum Galaxy, roughly 3 million light-years from Earth. The means of SCP-2399's travel to our solar system and the means of its communications are all unknown. From 1971 to 1985, SCP-2399 continuously received a single encoded message, which through code-breaking and translation efforts appeared to be a command to repair the damage it incurred upon entering our solar system. After this time, the barrier array was established to intercept these messages. This coincided with a period of radio silence from the origin of the communications until 1996, when a different order began transmitting. The barrier array has thus far prevented SCP-2399 from receiving this command. See Addendum 2399 comm log. SCP-2399 Discovery Notes. SCP-2399 was originally observed, albeit unknowingly, by Giovanni Cassini in 1665. The following is taken directly from Cassini's journal on the event, translated from Italian to English. October 8th, 1665. I have observed something extraordinary in the heavens. Last night, as I gazed through my looking glass, I saw what appeared to be a star of great luminescence streak through the far reaches of our solar system. I have never recorded an object moving so fast. It had surpassed the outer planets in fewer than 2 hours. As I watched by my own two eyes, I saw it slow as it closed on Jupiter, make a sharp turn, and disappear into the planet itself. I saw many bursts of light afterwards, but although I continued to peer at it until the sun broke, I saw no additional disturbances in the night sky. I must continue to document these changes, and will alert my colleagues when the day is upon me. October 15th, 1665. I took Peter to my observation point last night, but a week from the night I saw the fire rain upon Jupiter in the heavens. He brought along his own looking glass, and together we aimed our view upon the giant. To our surprise, a magnificent change has occurred. Where once the distant world only showed bands of color, there is now a great red spot where the star came to rest on the surface of Jupiter. Peter was incredulous, of course, that such an amazing discovery could have taken place before our very eyes. I will continue to take note of this. October 18th, 1665. Tonight, as I peered through my looking glass, I swear on my life I observed what looked to me like explosions and starbursts emanating from our red spot. I fear my mind is playing tricks on me, for there has been no record of such violent outbursts by a heavenly body since the dawn of astronomy. I will consult with Peter on the morrow, and hopefully glean from him some advice on the matter. October 19th, 1665. Peter sees the same as I. As I approached him with my concerns, he leveled the same with me, and through our following discussion, we concluded that it must be a powerful reaction to the falling star I saw upon the first night, and not a product of our own shortcomings. I am left wondering what cataclysmic event must be taking place upon our heavenly neighbor. Our work to document this must go on. Addendum 2399-2B. At hours on Barrier Unit 53 observed one of SCP-2399's repair drones closing on a piece of debris, quickly determined to be part of a damaged communications array. Because of the nature of this specific component and the ramifications of allowing SCP-2399 to recover it, it was ordered that Barrier Unit 45 fire upon the drone with its onboard concussion batteries. Batteries were discharged, however, the drone appeared undamaged. Footage obtained by Barrier Unit 53 shows that while the payload in question was launched towards the repair drone, it was destroyed within 5 kilometers of the target by additional charges originating from SCP-2399. Command lost contact with Barrier Unit 45 15 seconds after initial discharge, with video observation showing SCP-2399, the resulting spatial anomaly originating in the termination of Barrier Unit 45 by Barrier Units 44, 51, and 55. Under no circumstances are any barrier units to further engage SCP-2399 or drones released by SCP-2399. Addendum 2399-2C, Project Gygas. Information restricted to Level 4 personnel or above. Clearance accepted. After the events of it was decided that necessary force would be authorized to destroy or incapacitate SCP-2399. Using Foundation resources as well as resources from 45 nations, notably and a platform of warheads bearing megaton payloads and warheads bearing EMP detonators was launched and placed in orbit around Europa, on at hours with orders from 15 heads of state and 05, 05, 05, 05, and 05. The entire payload of Project Gygas was launched towards SCP-2399. Data expunged. Efforts to develop alternative methods of eliminating SCP-2399 are currently underway. Footnote 1. The repair of SCP-1396 has been proposed, but has been deemed currently unfeasible. Addendum 2399-L5. Information restricted to Level 4 personnel or above. Clearance accepted. So, SCP-2399. Have you ever sat and wondered, maybe after you hear about a car accident on a street you were just on, or a bombing in a city you were visiting, just how lucky you are to be alive? Just how many things have to go right for you to continue to exist? A few seconds too late, a few seconds too early, and somebody reaches for something they dropped, and a busload of people run into another busload of people. Sometimes this kind of thing does happen, as we've seen far too often. But that's what we're here for, to protect those who can't protect themselves from things that they wouldn't even know to protect themselves from. We can't do it all, though. As many things as we've been able to contain, as many things as we've been able to keep under lock that would threaten to destroy us all, still far too many remain that we can't do anything about. Whether they're too big or too fast or too powerful, any of these things could blink and wipe humanity from existence. The fact that they haven't done so yet is just luck. SCP-2399, however, is different. We have little information regarding SCP-2399's motives, origins, and full capabilities. We do not understand how it is capable of communicating over such large distances, or why those who constructed it, if it was in fact constructed, sent it to us in the first place. We do not know what would happen if SCP-2399 is able to fully repair itself, or if part of our array would break down and a message would get through. We do not know this, so we must assume the worst. Judging by what we've seen, were SCP-2399 to have reached Earth, it would have led to our timely destruction. But sometimes, humanity gets a little help. Sometimes, something steps in the way of the apocalypse. For us, and for SCP-2399, it was Jupiter. As SCP-2399 began to slow on its approach to Earth, Cassini saw what we've been able to ascertain, that SCP-2399 struck Io, was damaged, and was unable to escape the gravitational pull of Jupiter. Its weapons activated as they were intended, but it was Jupiter that experienced doomsday, not us. Eventually, though, it's likely that SCP-2399 will resume full functionality, and will likely be able to pull away from Jupiter and proceed to its target. As of now, we can keep hurling bombs and EMPs at it all we want, but we've got no indication that any of it will so much as scratch the thing. On the contrary, experience dictates it would do nothing at all. If this were to happen now, we would undoubtedly be destroyed. Jupiter has given us time. For now, SCP-2399 will remain there, reassembling itself, while we devise some way to stop it. Like it or not, we are in an arms race with this thing. Our best guesses give us something like 25 years until it's able to hear past our dampening array. Until then, we must seize the opportunity that has been laid before us. We must use the time we have been given and not let it be wasted. So, we devised Protocol Legionnaire. One gigantic EMP, powered by God knows what, followed by a volley of nukes big enough to wipe out our civilization 1,000 times over. A blunt plan, and simple, and likely futile. Our researchers and researchers around the globe have yet to devise a way to even deliver that kind of pulse, let alone a way to power it. There is no indication whatsoever that we'll be able to complete Legionnaire on time, or if it'll do what is intended once it is completed. But we must try. We must do something. Even if we have to drain our banks and empty our minds, we must try. Not often do we get a chance to see the swerving bus that will end our lives and step out of the way. Jupiter, unknowingly, has offered us that chance. I suggest we take it. Randall McAllen, Director, Barrier Project, Site. Addendum 2399, Comm Log. Information restricted to Level 4 personnel or above. We saw the sound and heard the light. All messages logged are to be understood as having repeated themselves continuously until either a new message is logged or a logged instance of radio silence. 1971. Unit is damaged. Repair. 1985. Updating orders. Maintain position. Repair. 1985. Period of radio silence. Barrier array is established. 1996. Unit is out of range of target. Proceed to planet number 3 in system. Repair. 2015. Unit is out of range of target. Proceed to planet number 3 in system. Priority is target. Cease repairs. Thank you guys so much for watching, and a huge thank you to all of my patrons on Patreon. Special shout out to my level 4 patrons, Alexis Zagrate, Ryan, and Lesby Friends. If you would like to see your name at the end of my videos, see my videos early, and get some other cool perks, head on over to patreon.com/drmaxwell. Link in the description.